We are really thrilled to introduce you tonight to a guest that we've had in the vocal department for the last couple of weeks. This is Mr. Richard Washington at the piano, and he has been a mentor for several of our students and a guide and an inspiration in helping us to prepare this song for you. We cannot thank him enough for inspiring us and helping us to live up to the potential that we have been given in this life. So thank you, Mr. Washington.
Thank you. At this time, we'd like to bring down one of our incredible kids. If you were at Les Mis, you saw a little fella do Monsieur Thénardier. And Monsieur Thénardier was just wild and crazy, but yet the fella can really play the piano as well. He's a sophomore, Austin, and we're so proud of him, so he's going to do his honoring of Amazing Grace.
I'd like to welcome Skylar Worf. She's an alumni, SOA alumnus, and she graduated in the class of 2020. She's a vocal major. She is still singing at Furman, and she is going to open up our first joint piece with His Eyes on the Sparrow, along with a junior, Linnea Ransford.
Because Thank you. there comes a time when we heed a certain call, when the world must come together as one. There are people dying, and it's time to lend a hand to life, the greatest gift of all.
Thank you.
I could have our Vocal Booster Club officers come on down. Anybody know a fourth grader that is getting your nerves lately? She hates it. They have to sing. And then Miss Janet White. She's been with us quite a long time too. So she has John Jr., William, and Susan. William and Susan are still here. Lynn has Emily, who graduated a while ago. She was in eighth grade when I started. Abby, who's sitting right here, who graduated in 2020. And then Olivia, who is a sophomore. So thank you. And then we're especially wanting to recognize you, Marianne Walsh. She has Ashley, who is a senior. And we think that we are going to let Ashley graduate. And then, of course, we're going to be losing Marianne. Well, so we'll see, Ashley. We'll see. But I just want to thank you so much for your support over the years, and we hope that your family will continue to be involved with the Singers for a very long time in the future. Thank you, guys. Embarrass you, just right alone, by yourself. Come on down, Carla Lathberry. This whole event would not have happened. This whole event would not have happened if it wasn't for you. And I forget, how many years have you been doing this event? And she's going to continue to do it unless one of you steps up, and so no one gets to leave tonight until we have a coordinator for next year. And Carla has the beautiful, wonderful Sophia, who's a senior. I am thinking right now, I want to say, if it were not for music, we wouldn't have known the beautiful Miss Quinaya McCoy. We wouldn't have known. And we wouldn't have known the beautiful Miss Chandrea Smalls. We do this concert tonight in their memory. And I will go further to say, if it were not for music, I would not have known the precious Miss Shirley Bard, which many of you don't know, is Dr. Cook's mom, and she passed away just a couple of months ago. She loved this concert. She made Shannon play the songs from this concert year-round in preparation to come back for this concert. So Shannon's gonna play Total Praise in just a little bit, but there are so many people that we can think, I wouldn't have made that connection with that person if it wasn't for music. And so all of you, you can think of somebody in your lives that you made a connection with over a song or singing together. And this choir, this family, these other teachers, we're connected by one thing, and that's the music. And it's changed us. It's changed the whole path of our lives. So we sing remembering Miss Shirley, remembering Chandrea, remembering Quanaya, and all the relationships that we have formed in our lives because of the music. And now we're going to sing a fast song. So, and we've got the dynamic duo to sing.
Of the judgment. Great, no, 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 no. Very well, not telling.
right here. And Bryson Woods, senior. So the goal is to have all of you up, like by the end of the song. So we're still working, but if this next one doesn't get you, I'm not sure. So come on now.
Good time.
recognize this year's seniors. And so they're coming down. Have been ups and downs and sad times and really joyous times, and I have absolutely loved teaching every single one of you, and you will always hold a special place in our hearts, the whole choir and myself. And I just want to thank you for the positive example that you set for younger singers. I want to thank you for especially this year. Goodness, just the awesome year we've had. I was watching, I got a time hop from last year. And if you remember, at the end of the year, after the piano moved away from me like 5 or 6 feet while I was we were trying to do our outdoor concert, because that was the only way we could do it. And we couldn't hear each other, and we couldn't see each other's faces. And do you remember the song we sang? The slow one that the piano kept wandering around? You do not walk alone. And so that song came up just this week, and I was watching it and listening to it, and it was absolutely gorgeous. And the text of that song, you remember, may you see God's light in the path ahead, even if the road is dark, may you always here, even in your hour of sorrow, the gentle singing of the lark when times are hard. Do you remember? So, no, okay, fine. Anyway, I want you to know that I will be thinking of you as you are making your next steps in life, and we wish you the very, very best, and we hope to see you again in the future, and we look forward to seeing all the wonderful things you do with your lives. We love you.